Hi everyone, it's Sean at Vixen Digital here. We help you to get the right clicks. Now today I'm going to be showing you how to set up your very own Google AdWords account. I'm also going to be showing you how to set up your very first Google AdWords campaign. So stay tuned and all of this is coming right up. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is open up our browser. In this case, I'm going to be using Google Chrome. And we need to make ourselves a new Google account. So we need to make ourselves a Gmail account. So if you open up and you get to the Google homepage, you can click Gmail in the corner. Now in Gmail, you'll get this option to create account. So we're going to create an account and you need to put in all of your details on this form here. So I'm going to do this really, really quickly just to speed things up. In this circumstance, I'm going to use my name. And I'm going to choose a username. So it asks you to agree to the terms and the privacy agreement. You can read through this in your own time. I'm just going to skip for the purpose of this. I'm going to skip through. We are also going to have to verify our account. So I'm going to put in my telephone number to verify the account. So I'll just skip through this. Okay, so I've verified my account with a phone number and I've got myself a new Gmail address all nice and set up. So I'm going to continue to Gmail. So you can continue to Gmail and it will show you your email or Gmail account. Okay, so I'm just going to close this tab here. It's going to give me some nice little emails. But at the moment, we're not interested in this because we're looking at setting up AdWords. So I'm just going to close this, open up a new tab and close this down. Oops. So I'm going to open up myself a new tab and I'm simply just going to type in AdWords. So now I can start setting up an AdWords account. So if I go to the AdWords page, it will ask me to start now or sign in. So I'm going to sign in. Okay, so I'm going to use the password that I made with my account. Okay, and it'll take you to this page. So the first thing we want to do is actually, for this tutorial, we're going to skip the guided setup. So I want you to skip this here by clicking this button. And here's just some details that you got to fill in. So if we just save and continue, if everything is correct. Okay, and now AdWords is going to be taking us through to the new 2018 Google AdWords interface. Okay, so here we are. So as we can see, this is the new 2018 Google AdWords interface. So here on the left-hand side, we can see that we have our customer ID, and we can see that this Google AdWords is actually in the beta, so it's a beta feature. So this Google AdWords interface at the moment is still undergoing testing, so there are still quite a lot of bugs in there. So in future videos, we will be switching between the new AdWords and the old AdWords. Okay, now we've got our campaign set up. You can add your billing information by clicking on the little spanner and then also going down to billing and payments. However, I'm just going to get straight into it and ask you to start and show you how to start your very first campaign. So we're going to go to campaigns on the left hand side and we've got this little plus symbol. So we're going to click this plus symbol and actually just click this new campaign. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward. So here you'll get a series of options. We're going to be focusing on setting up a search campaign, okay, for the Google search network. So I'm going to click on this one, okay, and I'm going to not use any of these. Now you can use some of these if you wish, but for the purpose of this one, I'm going to take you through without using these. So I want you to create a campaign without a goal. And then here it will also ask you to select the results that you want to get from your campaign. So at the moment, because we're not entirely sure what the results are, I'm just going to press continue. So we don't necessarily need to put these details in. Okay, so we're going to be setting up. So we're going to pretend that we've got a pizza restaurant and we're going to be advertising our pizza takeaway. So that's going to be name of the campaign because we want to get people we want to advertise to people who are looking for pizza takeaway. And we want this to be a search network campaign. And we're also going to include Google Search Partners, but we're not going to add a display network. Okay, so the display network for showing banner ads. Now, we want to search, let's pretend that we want London. So we're in London and we just want to target the whole of London city centre, which will come up at the top. So if you type in the name here, London, and we're going to target London. Okay, and we're just going to be targeting London. Now, languages, customers speak English. Now, you might also want to include other languages if you want to attract. Obviously, London's a very big city with many languages spoken, so you might want to add a few separate languages. But for the purpose of this tutorial, we're going to just stick with English and keep it simple. Bidding, we're going to set our bidding strategy here to manual CPC. Okay, so manual cost per click. That means that we are going to be controlling how much we're willing to pay for a click on our ad. Now we're not going to go in with enhanced CPC here, so leave this unchecked. And budget per day, let's just say we want to spend £10 to make it easy. Okay, and we're just going to click delivery method and make sure that it's on standard. And we're going to go down. And we just want to have a look and check these, but we also want to go to additional settings and we want to find location options. Okay, so remember that we selected London in our location. Well, if we are targeting here people in or show interest in our target locations, so this is the one that's recommended by Google. However, this will make your ads eligible to show across many different continents, many different countries, because somebody might be taking interest in London and they might just simply want to search for, I don't know, pizza in London. So your ads could be showing to anybody around. So we want people that are actually in our target locations. Okay, and that's one way and a little way to actually save our budget in the future. Okay, at the moment, you can also do this with exclude the exclusions, so your excluded locations. But at the moment, we're just going to leave this as this one. Okay, so as we scroll down, we're going to save and continue. And now it comes to our ad groups. So our campaign is called Pizza Takeaway. And our first ad group is going to be, as to make it as granular as possible, we're going to name our ad group per keyword. So we're only going to put one keyword in each ad group to make it as granular as possible and to give us the most control over the account. So let's say we actually want to bid on the term pizza takeaway. Okay, so when anyone searches for pizza takeaway, we want to bid on that. So we're actually going to name our ad group the same as what our keyword is. We're just going to have a default bid of, say, £1, just for now. And as you can see down here, it gives you an idea of what match types to choose. Okay, so in this circumstance, let's just say that we're going to use a exact match type. So we're going to use exact and we're going to have pizza takeaway. Now, this exact match type will only show, so our ad will only show when someone searches for this specific term. So if someone searches for pizza takeaway, then our ad will show. Okay? It won't show if someone searches for example, best pizza takeaway. So we keep it as pizza takeaway and we'll show just for pizza takeaway. Now, in order to make sure that we don't get confused here, I'm just going to give this ad group a label with an E and some brackets. And this reminds me that this is an exact match. Okay? So we're going to add another ad group and we are going to add the ad group is going to be exactly the same as the previous ad group. So we're going to have pizza takeaway again. We're going to give it the same just default bid of just a pound, but we're going to add a different match type. So we're going to add pizza takeaway but we're going to go for a broad match. Now, we're not going to go for a total broad match. We're actually going to use something called a broad match modifier. So a broad match gives, well, Google, if you have just, if we just enter this pizza takeaway, and this would is what Google would recognize as a broad match. Now, the broad match, Google will find loads of really, really wide related search terms that it will attach and show your ads for. So, for example, you could show, if you were bidding on this search term, you could show for things such as Indian takeaway, Chinese takeaway, Mexican takeaway. You could show for the best takeaway in London. You could also show for things such as the worst takeaway in London. So the problem with just having a broad match is that you will spend a lot of budget on things that might not necessarily be very relevant to your business. So the way we get around that is actually by adding a plus and a plus to just before the keywords. So we've added these pluses to the before the keywords, which means that Google now will only show our ads for search terms that include both of these terms. So the search term will have to include pizza and it will have to include takeaway. Okay, so we've got these two ad groups. Now I'm going to make sure that I've got the broad match modifier here in brackets so I know the difference between my two. So I've got an exact match pizza takeaway and I've got a pizza takeaway broad match modifier. Okay, so you can keep on building your campaigns as much as you want to with whichever search terms you want. Please bear in mind to be as granular as possible so it gives you the maximum control over your account. But for just for this tutorial, I'm going to save and continue. And then it takes us through to create some of our ads. So I'm going to create an ad for the pizza takeaway exact match. And let's just say that our URL is www.pizzainlondon.com. And as you can see on the ad preview, this starts to appear. So we want our first headline to be as near the original search term, or we want it to be as near the original keyword as possible. So in this circumstance, it's pizza takeaway. So I'm going to just put pizza takeaway in my first headline to make it as relevant as possible. So pizza takeaway, and let's just say that we do, let's just say that we are the best pizza in London. Best pizza in London. Okay, and just make a note that these sections do have character limits, so you have to be very, very clever with your creatives and your ad copy wording. We have things called paths here as well, which gives us like a look, so we can actually add more keywords into it. So we can say like /takeaway and it appears over here. And a nice description. So we've got a maximum of 80 characters. So we could say free delivery on all orders. Best pizza, or let's say award winning pizza buy one, get one free. By now. So it's always good in your descriptions or at some point in your ad to actually give a real strong call to action. So here's something as well, just a little tip, is that I've put two exclamation marks here as well. So what we'd have to do, Google will probably disapprove this ad because I've got two exclamation marks. So if I was to take this one out, put a full stop instead, then that would probably be accepted now by Google. So another thing that we can do and another option that you might want to consider is that you can also use a different URL if you've got a mobile website, so if someone is searching on their phone. So if you have a different URL, you can input it by checking this box and inputting your website here. But in this circumstance, we're not going to be doing that. So we've got the preview over here, so we can take another look at our preview. We can have a desktop preview. So this is how our ad's going to look on a desktop, and this is how our ad is going to look on a tablet or a mobile. Okay, so if we're happy with that, we can go ahead and press done. And then we can create another ad, or exactly the same ad, for, so let me just copy this. And we can create exactly the same ad again for your broad match modifier one. So I'll just do that very quickly. Okay, so we get to the end. So we've got both of our ads, and then we can save and continue. So once we get save and continue, Google takes us to this review page where we can review everything that we set up. So here are some daily estimates that Google will give you. They're not always accurate, but they're good to kind of take note of when you're kind of thinking about what kind of budget you're going to assign to this campaign. If you're all happy with everything here, then you can just go to continue to campaign. And there we have it. So our campaign is now ready. It's set. It's all ready to go. We've got ads running for it. The next thing that you need to do is to actually add your billing information, because Google will not run your ads until you've added your billing information. Okay, so I hope that was informative, and good luck with your very first campaign, and I hope to see you again soon. Thanks a lot.